What's up, y'all? Welcome back in the shop. Today I got some rebar here, and I'm going to be making a hook that I can use to drag transmissions that are on a small type pallet, and also some small motors off my trailers when I'm towing cars. And I'm just going to weld two pieces together, put a T-handle on it, torch, spin the hook, and all that good stuff. So let's get into it here. normally when I do these bends like this, I would do like a double heat treat. So I would heat it up white hot, or as red hot as I could get it, and then quench it and heat it up to about 580 to 600 degrees, and you'd know that temperature by color. When it turns just a slight blue, almost purple, but not quite, is when you quench it the second time, and it's right at about 600 degrees. But because I'm just going to be using this as a kind of like a baiter hook, and it'll be plenty hard enough just quenching it the once. I'm not going to worry about doing it like I would tool steel. But there you go, and I'll probably paint it. But I'm going to go try it out and see how it works. And there you go. Hook for pulling around pallets. And obviously, if you got a very big motor on one, you're going to have to be pretty strong. But most of the time, I'm just doing transmissions and small car motors, so it'll work perfect. Thanks for watching. Until next time. This is the type of pallet that I'm normally dragging around. It's like a 3 foot by 3 foot. But took that in there like that and just bag it. It slides pretty easy on asphalt, and my trailer's just a flat deck steel trailer. So it'll work out pretty well, even some of these bigger ones. I mean, it's not ideal, but in a pinch, when I don't have a forklift and I just need to slide it off there, I could just drag around, assuming the pallet doesn't fall apart like that. But yeah, and they slide, they really do slide pretty easy. That way, when I get to an outsource shop to drop off a car and a motor or a transmission, and they ain't got a forklift around, or they're busy, I can just pull it off and be on my way.